Steve Gould, third generation dairy farmer. My wife Jill, and we're located halfway between Rochester and Buffalo in New York State. So my grandparents started the farm in 1956. Their names are Harold and Rose, and that's where the name HaR-Go comes from. It stands for Harold and Rose Gould. For us, in organic certification, it's the only nitrogen source we can use as animal manure. So we store as much of it as we can so we can use it in times when it is most useful, which is before you plant and after you harvest. I guess storage is important because of the seasonality in New York State. So there's a lot of times when the ground's too wet, there's too much rain, there's too much snow. Well, it's not a good time to spread for runoff, for water quality. So you store it when it's dry. You can get out on the fields without making a lot of mud, pulling a lot of mud on the road, and you get the best utilization of it from the crops. We sample fields every 3 years. We're on a three-year rotation for sampling, which checks for phosphorus, potassium, and nitrogen. Based on those results and our manure sampling, that gives us a prescription of how much manure per acre. That's how we plan on what we put on each year. Almost all of our manure is injected right into the soil. That puts the manure under the dirt while limiting how much disturbance to the soil surface there is. Cover crop is a crop that goes in after your main crop that keeps the soil covered in the non-growing season. Protects against erosion, so anytime you can have something more moist and porous, you can get water into the soil and keep it from running off. Yeah, the managing of the pasture is a big part of my job. We have three different groups of animals on pasture, a couple hundred acres of pasture. You graze them and you gotta let them regrow and keep a rotation based on the grass growth, keep a good mix of legumes and grass. We try to graze as much animals on an acre as we can, as short a period of time as we can. But that helps concentrate the animals to a single area, and they'll eat the grass better the tighter you keep the paddock, and then they'll get the manure a little more concentrated on the area. So anywhere we can utilize the animals to put the nitrogen into a growing plant, that's what we try to do. Grasses are just a great filter, a natural filter, for keeping things on the ground you want to keep in the ground. Especially like during big rain events, a rooted plant holds the soil better than anything else. Yeah, we have a small creek that runs through the center of the farm. It feeds a reservoir. Ground next to the creek is in CRP, which is a government program. They'll rent land from you as long as you keep it in like a buffer. And a buffer is basically just naturally growing grass that allows filtration. So if you do have any runoff, it doesn't make it directly into the creek. I enjoy the complexity of the system and working to solve environmental problems. They're working to improve the animal welfare, and you know, just making it a better farm is a very complex thing. I guess I enjoy attacking those challenges. And dairy is certainly a backbone of this area of New York State. So it's more than just the farm, it's the people and it's the animals.
Yeah, it's an economic and environmental and like a community multiplier. And that's, I think, what we really love. Dairy farming lets us do that.